There are many applications where systems of equations are useful. Oftentimes, the hardest part of solving a problem like this is setting up the system itself and not the actual solving. What we're going to do is go through several different applications and set up the systems that we'll use to solve them, but not actually solve them. In this problem, we're told that we have a jar containing 300 coins, each of which is either gold or silver. Gold coins have a value of $8, while silver coins have a value of $2, and we know that the total value of the jar is $1,800. Our goal is to set up a system that will let us determine how many of each coin we have. Since we care about the number of each type of coin we have, it makes sense for us to define variables that represent those quantities. So we could say X could be the number of gold coins, and Y could be the number of silver coins. Now we need to say something about X and Y. Notice that we're really given two separate pieces of information in this problem. We are told the total number of coins that we have, and we're also told the total value of those coins. Each of those pieces of information is going to lead to a separate equation. Let's start with the total number of coins. We know that we have a total of 300 coins, and so we know probably something is going to be equal to 300. Well, each of those coins is either gold or it's silver. So if we take the number of gold coins and we add to it the number of silver coins, that should add up to 300 coins. Well, the number of gold coins is X, and the number of silver coins is Y. So, algebraically, we would say that X plus Y is 300. That's the first equation in our system. Now let's talk about the value. We are told that we have a total value in the jar of $1,800. So we need to take our variables X and Y that represent the number of each coin and convert those into a value. The number of gold coins we have is X, but what would their value be? Well, each one is worth $8. Therefore, if we take the number of coins we have and we multiply it by the value of each coin, that will tell us the total value of our coins. In other words, we have X coins, each of them is worth $8, and so the total value of them is 8X. Similarly, with the silver coins, we have Y silver coins, each one is worth $2, and so the total value of those coins is 2y. Now we know that the total value in the jar is 1800, and so if we take the value of our gold coins and add to it the value of our silver coins, that should equal 1800. In other words, 8x plus 2y equals 1800. That's the second equation in our system. So our two equations are X plus Y equals 300 and 8X plus 2Y equals 1800. And from here we can solve and get the exact values of X and Y. Before we jump into making equations here, we need to get a handle on the quantities that are involved. In this case, we are already told that we have X, which is the dollars invested at 6% per year, and then we also have Y, which is the dollars invested at 11% per year. We're asked to create two equations involving these two variables, X and Y. Well, let's start with the total size of the investment, $6,600. If we take the amount of money in the first investment and add to it the amount of money in the second investment, that should be the total size of the investment, $6,600. And there's our first equation. We can follow a similar strategy to come up with a second equation involving the interest. We know that we have $636 worth of interest that we're going to get, and it comes from two sources. It comes from the X investment and it comes from the Y investment. So what we can say is we're going to have a total of $636 in interest, and it's going to come from two places. on the one hand, we will have the interest from 6% account. And on the other hand, we'll have the interest from the 11% account. If we can come up with expressions for those two quantities, we can then add them together, and the total should be 636. So what can we say about those two quantities? Well, we know that we have X dollars invested into an account that accrues 6% per year. And so the interest that you gain over the course of a year is 6% of X. Well, if we translate that into a mathematical statement, it would be 0.06 for 6%. Of means multiply, and then X is the size of the account. So that's 0.06X. We can do something similar with the 11% account. We know that the interest from that is going to be 11% of the amount of money in that account, which in this case is Y. So translating that would be 0.11 for 11% times Y, which is the amount of money in the account. So 0.11Y. So on the one hand, this is our interest from the 6% account, and this is our interest from the 11% account. Let's put those values into our equation, and that will complete our system. 0.06x plus 0.11y equals 636. So we have our first equation here, which involves the total amount of the investment, and we have our second equation here, which involves the interest from that investment. In this problem, we're told that we have created 250 milliliters of a solution that is 35% alcohol. And we know that it came from a mixture of a solution that is 20% alcohol and a solution that is 50% alcohol. And what we would like to know is how much of each of those two things went into the final mixture. They have helpfully told us here that X is supposed to represent the amount of the 20% solution, and that Y is supposed to represent the amount of the 50% solution. And we're going to try and come up with a system of equations involving X and Y. What we'll be able to do is create one equation using the total volume of the solution, and another equation dealing specifically with the alcohol content of that solution. For the first equation, we know that we ended up with a total of 250 milliliters of solution. Well, where did that come from? It came from the 20% solution, and it came from the 50% solution. Since those were the only two ingredients, what we can say is that the amount of the 20% solution plus the amount of the 50% solution must add up to those 250 milliliters. For the second equation, we can look specifically at the alcohol of the solution. We know that the alcohol came from two places. We have the alcohol from the 20% solution, and we're also going to have alcohol from the 50% solution. And we're going to add those two things together, and that should add up to the total alcohol in the final solution. So let's see if we can come up with values for each of those three quantities. For the 20% alcohol solution, it was 20% of however much of the solution we have is going to be alcohol. So 20% of X, that's 0.20 times X. That's how much alcohol we got from the 20% solution. Same idea for the 50% solution. 50% of Y is the amount of alcohol that we got from that solution. So that would be 0.50 times Y. We can put those two quantities in on the left-hand side of our equation. 0.20X plus 0.50y. The last thing to do is to fill in the right-hand side of that equation, where we need to put the total amount of alcohol in the final solution. Well, we can follow the same pattern. We know that 35% of that final solution is supposed to be alcohol. And how much was it? It was 250 milliliters. So we can say 0.35 times 250, that gives us 87.5. That tells us the amount of alcohol in the final solution, and that goes in on this side, 87.5.